Welcome to another episode of How It Works with Holger. Today, for the first time on How It Works with Holger, I would like to talk about FlexCel. And in case you're new to FlexCel and haven't heard about it, this will be brilliant because I'm going to give you three things you don't know about FlexCel if you've never heard of FlexCel. And of course, I'm also going to tell you how to get started. In order to get started, you need to know what FlexCel is. Listening to the name or seeing it written on screen, you might have figured out it has to do with Microsoft Excel. And that's exactly what it is. However, FlexCel can do much, much more. You might think you can create an Excel file and open an Excel file. However, there's much, much more to it. Okay, so let's start with the three things you most likely won't know. First of all, Excel is not required. Why would you need Excel? You say, like, well, if you use Office Automation, that uses ActiveX objects from an existing Office Excel installation. So Excel needs to be installed in order to import data from Excel or push data towards Excel. That's something you see in Delphi applications quite a lot, actually. With FlexCel, you do not need that. You neither need Excel during development on the development machine, nor do you need it for production. It also means you can compile your application without having Excel installed, which is not the case if you use Office Automation. Then you need the libraries in order to compile your application and also to run your application because you create a dependency on Excel. That is something you might not want. And with FlexCel, you're not doing it. However, Excel, having it installed during development, is encouraged because that opens up the world of FlexCel even more, but more about that later. Second, there's a tool that teaches you how to use FlexCel. It's called API Mate, and it's brilliant because it allows you to take an Excel file and it will show you the code, how you would generate that Excel file using FlexCel. Brilliant. And third of all, reporting. For me, FlexCel is my number one reporting engine. I don't use anything else. I use FlexCel. I create a template in Excel. That's why it's advantageous to have Excel installed as well. And then you can create, inside of this template, you can create tags. And these tags will get replaced with your database, with your list, with your objects, whatever you define. You have full control over all of that. So FlexCel is also a reporting engine with preview and everything. And one more thing, or call it a one-off error, FlexCel can create PDF, HTML, and all sorts of image files. So you cannot only create an Excel file, you can also create a PDF file as a result of your report or an HTML file. And because FlexCel is neatly encapsulated, you can even use FlexCel inside of TMS XData, for example, which allows you to create reports for your web applications, because then your XData backend, your web service, returns the PDF and your browser shows the PDF. The best thing, FlexCel is available for almost anywhere. So you have multiple frameworks, for example, here the VCL, FireMonkey, .NET, and more. For example, Lazarus, I think, is being tested right now. You also have various languages. It's not only Delphi. It is also available for C#, for example. And I know there's other languages in the works as well. So always check the webpage on TMS Software, what is available. And if you just want to add FlexCel functionality to something that you already have, it's even available as a DLL. So let's get started with a very simple example. This will give you the foundation that you need when you open up the documentation to start somewhere. And after showing you this example, I'm going to show you API Mate that will allow you to dive in even faster. So I started with a very simple VCL application, Windows, nothing fancy, Delphi 11, drop the button calls create Excel file, and that's where we'll start. First, you have to use vcl.flexcel.core if it is a VCL application. If it is a FireMonkey application, it has to be fmx.flexcel.core. This unit needs to be used at least once. If you forget about this unit, you'll get an error message as soon as you invoke the first FlexCel message. Just make sure to look up in the documentation if you use a different framework that you use the correct core unit. Furthermore, we need to use the XLS adapter. This unit contains classes needed to create Excel content and open Excel content. So with that, we can declare our variable reference that will be the reference to the Excel file. So we called it LXLS file. And the class is TXLS file. There is also, I'm just putting it out there, there's also something like TXL file. That is a base class that we don't need. We use one not higher in the hierarchy, deeper in the hierarchy, or more specialized to create files. And we also need a counter variable I for loop, just for a simple example. And we create our object instance of the class txlsfile.create. And we have quite a few overloads for the constructor. You can create it from streams. If you already have a stream with Excel information in there, for example, you can also load a file. And in this case, we want to create a new file. So we specify the sheet count, sheet. Basically, the terminology in Excel is you have a workbook, that's the whole file, and each workbook contains multiple sheets. That's the terminology. So we're going to use one sheet, and from that, the file format, very important, TXL file format, and code completion is a great help here. These are all the different distinct file formats that Microsoft actually introduced for Excel. I wasn't even aware that there was a change between 21, 19, and 16. So I'm just going to use the newest file format. Of course, if you want to be compatible, most compatible, you're going to go down in the file format. Just be aware of the fact that Microsoft introduced the XLSX file format in 2010, and the XLS file format was used before that. And both are supported by FlexCel. So using this. And then the third parameter, allow overwriting files. That is something that will follow you with FlexCel as a Boolean parameter all the time. If you don't want to overwrite something and just read, for example, you can set this to false. Of course, because if we're creating this document, so this has to be true. And also, if we save this document to disk, and the file would already be there, we would get an error message or an exception, to be more precise, that the file already exists. So with true, we can overwrite when we want to. And of course, this has to be freed. So FlexCel is not using interfaces behind the scenes. This is a true class, so we have to free the reference after using it. So just looking at all the methods that are available, it's gigantic. It's literally Excel mapped to a Delphi class. It's amazing. The method that we'll use is setCellValue. And again, there's so many overloads with so many different variations because you can write through different sheets. If you just setCellValue, it's the current sheet. So there's also a property that allows you to change the current sheet inside of your workbook, and all these things are supported. So just a simple hello world in this case is setCellValue 1, 1, hello world. And that is the biggest difference, and that's why I made the joke in the beginning. The biggest difference in the Microsoft world with Excel, they start counting with one. So in Delphi terminology, we would say 0, 0, which would be the first cell in the document. But in this case, Excel actually uses 1, 1, maybe because, you know, the whole Visual Basic story and the VBA stuff is all one base. So I think that's where that all comes from. So with regards to rows, the row is also first. That is also something that might not be common. Usually the X coordinate is first, but in this case, It's the row first, so it's the first row. And then this is literally A, B, C in the Excel document, starting with 1. So 1, 1 should be the upper left A1 in an Excel document. So at this point, the document only exists in memory. So in order to store it, we have to call save. So LXLS file, save. And we have multiple overloads. Yet again, you can even change the file format if you wanted to. So the simplest one is just the file name, save, drive G, root directory, hello world, .xlsx. And with that, it should compile. And when we run this, click and go to that directory now. So PC, drive G, there's our hello world xlsx, double click, and right there is our hello world in A1. And just to make this a little bit more complicated, that you see how this works, for is1 to 10 to begin, and then we say set cell value i, and be certain to close it, because even if you set override to true, Excel holds an exclusive lock, so you have to close it, but now it will override after clicking the button, if you close the application, of course. So we restart this, and then we should be able to create a new document. Poof, that's it. And once again, double click on the file, and there you go, we have our for loop generating the content. So just to get you a little bit excited, in the next episode, I'm going to show you the reporting functionality. So if I have here, for example, an album by Michael Jackson, I click print, then this preview here is all FlexCel. So it also has a visual control that you can use for previews, but this can then also be generated as a PDF or an Excel file. The key thing here is that this is based on this template. You specify where your cover goes in this case, the title, the name of the artist, then you can have content that spans multiple lines. And if you look closely in the Excel document here, this only spans up to the not full size of the cover image, but still, if you look at the report, this expands. So I have even the option to say, hey, expand this, and then I define the range that gets repeated over and over and over again for each record inside of my data set. And this is what I defined here. And that ends up as a full report of the album. Now that I've shown you how to get started with the FlexCel API, writing all the different lines of code in order to generate an Excel document, you might wonder, what are all the methods and classes that I need? And the best tool to get you started is API Mate. And what API Mate does, it generates the code for an existing Excel document. So taking again my template for the report that I just showed you, I can generate the code for this template. That's also a good means to include your templates inside of your Pascal project. If you don't want any dependencies on files or resources, you just include the code to generate the template as well. So you select the source code that you want to create, because this also creates C++ code, for example. So here, let's say open file. I already pasted the path tracks.xlsx. And here is the source code to generate this file. If you look at it closely, it even sets up the two sheets that I have in here, because I have one sheet which is named sheet one. The second one is named config. So that's all being taken care of. It's very, very detailed. So all your printer options, for example, also get passed. But the key is here. Look at how complex that is to set all the different sizes, widths of the cells. It merges the cells accordingly, automatically. And then, of course, it sets the content of each of the cells. And there is no easier way than using API Mate to learn how to actually set data inside of a cell, for example. So you have your XLS file, as you've just seen. This is the variable XLS. That's the TXLS file. And then you can get the format for a certain cell. And then you can assign the font name, the font size, and all these things. The style is bold. And API Mate gets you there, how to do it. And you can make slight modifications. That's what I said, why it's beneficial to have Excel ready. So you, for example, design one line, how it's supposed to look like, and then you convert that into a method in your Pascal program that is being iterated over and over and over again. And that way you can also generate your Excel document that looks a certain way. So you're not bound to any reporting functionality per se. And also you can have conditional formatting this way in a way without using Excel, but doing it yourself in your source code. So the flexibility is amazing. What API Mate also does, it immediately allows you to specify what you want to get as an output. For example, right now I get an Excel document, but it could also check PDF, and it adds all the lines that you need to have in order to export your document as a PDF document. It's really not possible to do this any easier. It's near perfect. One final thing before I let you go. One of my books actually has the reporting functionality explained. It's in Hands-On 1, Cross-Platform Multi-Tiered Database Applications. And if you look at the book right here, this is what the book looks like. That book has details on how you can build a web service with PDF generation. But if you're not interested in the web service part, of course you can take the FlexCel parts, how to generate a PDF report, for example, based on a database. That's a wrap for another episode of How It Works with Holger. Live long and prosper, and see you soon.